Breaking famous Trump basher just did it. This is sick on all levels, his life is over. There's no shortage of Trump detractors, resistance standers, and people who will risk their entire careers to go against him. It's become the most popular trend in sports and entertainment at the massive cost of revenue loss and risk to the industry as a whole. It's clear that those who hate him the most have a lot to hide that they felt safe getting away with while Barack Hussein Obama was in office. Speaking out against Trump without ceasing despite the warnings, never seems to end well when you have skeletons in the closet you're trying to hide or anything else to lose. One of the president's famous haters just found out this out the hard way as the latest to bite the dust on his achievements. Earlier this week, we reported about gold medalist skier Lindsey Vonn, who preempted her competition in the 2018 Olympics with making divisive statements about our president. Rather than unifying the world, which this event is designed to do, she stabbed the commander-in-chief in the back with an announcement that she will now be representing him in her sport on the world stage. She was not asked for her opinion on the president or even about politics. The tactless commentary served no other purpose than to stick it to our president where it wasn't needed. However, Vonn isn't the only one this week committing catastrophic career suicide. In addition to trashing Trump, there has been a secondary movement sweeping the nation from the liberal left. It takes a direct aim at holding powerful men accountable for sexual harassment, misconduct, and assault, has now named a prominent liberal serial harasser. It's now being reported that a famous Trump basher forced women to have sex with him for employment. Seems like a common workplace practice for liberals who like to talk about Trump's grab 'em comment, which is no comparison to their rape 'em routine. The left lost another prominent voice tonight, conservative commentator Mike Cernovich said, as news came out that PBS late-night talk show Tavis Smiley has been suspended from his prominent position after allegations of what's become the phrase of the decade, sexual misconduct. This is ironic considering this outspoken host made a living hating on our president, famously referring to him as a racial arsonist. It's a clever moniker coming from a man who allegedly forced women to have sex with him for a job. There's a lot of names he could be given for that. Effective today, PBS has indefinitely suspended distribution of Tavis Smiley, produced by TS Media, an independent production company, the public broadcaster said. PBS engaged an outside law firm to conduct an investigation immediately after learning of troubling allegations regarding Mr. Smiley. This investigation included interviews with witnesses as well as with Mr. Smiley. The inquiry uncovered multiple, credible allegations of conduct that is inconsistent with the values and standards of PBS, and the totality of this information led to today's decision. Sources close to the production told Variety that PBS hired attorney Sarah Taylor Wirtz of the firm MSK to oversee an investigation into Smiley's behavior after receiving allegations of misconduct by Smiley, who hosts and produces the talk show. Wirtz declined Variety's request for comment. According to sources, MSK took reports from 10 witnesses, a mix of men and women of different races and employment levels in Smiley's organization, most of them former staffers. The investigation found credible allegations that Smiley had engaged in sexual relationships with multiple subordinates, sources said. Some witnesses interviewed expressed concern that their employment status was linked to the status of a sexual relationship with Smiley. In general, witnesses described Smiley as creating a verbally abusive and threatening environment that went beyond what could be expected in a typical high-pressure work environment. Several expressed concerns about retaliation. In an attempt to save some face and whatever is left of his reputation, Smiley stuck it to his accusers by making the false claim that he respects women. "I have the utmost respect for women and celebrate the courage of those who have come forth to tell their truth. To be clear, I have never groped, coerced, or exposed myself inappropriately to any workplace colleague in my entire broadcast career, covering six networks over 30 years," Smiley said in a statement. The tactic of deflecting their own indiscretions by trashing Trump is not working anymore, except to prove Trump isn't actually the problem. It seems that for every right-wing leaning man who is accused of sexual misconduct, there are at least 100 liberal men accused of the same, or worse. This whole time all these institutions were being run as brothels and not one person in the outside world even knew. They tell us how to think and what is and isn't moral while at the same time their stench of immorality is off the charts.